All right. Hey, what's up, good people? So here's part two of my pencil drawing demo of Naomi Campbell wearing Alexander McQueen at her Relief for Haiti fashion show a few years ago during New York Fashion Week. All right. So on the first demo, I did a line drawing, the outline of it. Now I'm adding some shade. And the reason for that, I want to break the drawing in half. The light side versus the dark side. The light area versus the shadow area. So you can see there's a lot of shadow area. Here is the photo that I captured. All right, so you see a lot of shadow area here. Here's the runway. So I'm breaking it in half. And yeah, you hear a lot of music outside. That's my neighbors. So 25 minute demo. I'm gonna use a tortillion. This is paper. It helps blend the shading, so it helps smoothen it out. I already did one side here. Now I'm gonna blend the other side. The reason for doing this is to get a smooth surface. And this helps me separate Naomi from the background. Alright, so that's a nice start there. Blend it a little bit more. And I'm using the side of the tortillion. Not pointing at it, but using the side of it. Covers more surface. So there we go there. Next, I'm going to start shading in her hair. And I'm still using my 2H Caran d'Ache pencil. So this is an approximate of her hair. There's still a lot of detail to go, a lot of steps. So this is just placing things, building it up slowly. I'm resisting the urge to draw too detailed at the moment. I'm going to introduce some shading on the legs. It's going to be, you know, very boxy at the moment. I don't want it too detailed, too defined. I'd like it loose. Little detail, not too detailed. So the shadows help me define volume. It helps me shape one leg in front of the other. So this shadow is going to be a little bit darker here. And I'm going to change these shadows at least 100 times. So it's just a reference point. Still going to resist the urge to, I won't be drawing the fingers at the moment, but I will fill in some more shadow spaces. I'm going to start introducing shadows from the shoes, kind of give me some more reference points to work with. right, so now I'm gonna put some more tone down to signal skin tone a little bit. It'll help me still take her leg off of the runway. And you know, I need those visual references. I'm gonna adjust my curtain a bit. Sunlight's peeking in. Okay. I'm gonna add some tone to the chest and neck. Still not drawing the chin yet, not defining the face. Too early for that. When I eventually draw, say, each part of the neck, separating it by tone helps me. You hear my neighbors outside. Sorry for the profanity if you hear them. What I will start doing is I'll start peeling away some of these lines. They served as references, they served as guides. I don't need them so much now. And using this gum eraser, this clay eraser, you could think of these lines as scaffolding, helps me with the proportions of the drawing. But now I don't need the scaffolding as much. I have a shape in place. I've been avoiding these people up here. I'll start adding some tone to them. A little bit of shadow on her hair. It's a good idea to progress a whole drawing at once, not do everything here, then this, build it all gradually together. So that's it. Hope you all found it helpful. You could see more on YouTube, Sean Punch Drawing and Photography. So hey, peace out.